Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Fang Fang Talk. I'm Fang Fang. Our topic of today is sensation and perception. If you have any problem regarding this topic, you can call in our line. In related to our topic today, we have invited three honorable guests. This is Dr. Smithy, Dr. Candy, and Dr. Candy. As we know, stimulus is an object or event that elicits response in our sense organ. Sensation is the passive process that we take in the information via our five senses. But what are the differences between sensation and perception?
The difference between sensation and perception is how we process the information.
Firstly, in sensation, sensory receptors detect the stimulus and then transmit it to the brain. Once the brain receives it, this is where perception sets in. The process of organizing and interpreting the information is perception. After perception, people will be able to make sense of the information.
We have an audience who has a question for our experts. Let's have a look at this video. Why this lady has this kind of auditory focusing, like hearing someone is calling her name, but in fact the surrounding is noisy and disturbing?
This is actually a phenomenon of cocktail party effect.
What is cocktail party effect?
Cocktail party effect is a phenomenon of selective attention coined by an English cognitive scientist Colin Cherry in 1983.
As what the audience is experiencing, it describes a situation when someone can immediately detect the words of importance upon the unattended stimulus. It also describes another situation when you are in the busy cocktail party or other noisy events that you can focus on the conversation that you want to hear.
Why can we do that?
The brain helps you focus on only the person you are talking to. Until the extent that you can filter out other background stimulations that wasn't important in the conversation.
Why are the researchers and scientists are so interested in doing this study?
This kind of selective attention is actually a human survival skills, because with all those audio and visual stimulations out there, we cannot survive unless we can focus on only one. And also, with this study, they can also study the limitations of multitasking.
Thank you, Dr. Sweetie. We have a call in now. Let's listen.
Hello, I want to ask question about colorblindness. My husband is a colorblind and I recently know that I'm a carrier too. We are expecting a child now, so will he or she be affected by us?
So, Dr.
Candy,
will this child be affected?
Before giving you the answer, I want to explain what is colorblindness to the audience who doesn't know what colorblindness is. Okay. Generally speaking, colorblindness is a inherited illness from your family, which is causes from mutation of X chromosome. So, generally speaking, we have three types of colorblindness. The first one, which is the most common one, is the red and green colorblindness. The second one is blue and yellow. And the third one is total colorblindness.
Okay, since you mentioned that your husband is colorblind and then you are a carrier of colorblindness, you didn't mention that your child's gender, so I'm going to do a general explanation for you.
You mentioned that your husband is colorblind, so one of his X chromosome will be mutated. And you are a carrier, so one of your X chromosome will be mutated too. So when it passed down to your child, since you didn't mention, so if you have a son, your son will have 50% chances that he will be colorblind. another 50%, he will not get colorblind or carrier at all. But if you have a daughter, your daughter has 50% chances that she is a colorblind, another 50% chance that she is a carrier.
Dr. Candy, how can we know that the child has colorblindness and what is the effect of his or her future?
Yes, the colour test name is called Ishihara colour test, which you have a circle and a little dot. They have similar colours, so in colourblindness people, they cannot see a certain colour, they will know it. But for a child that young, who doesn't familiar with the number yet, you can use an object like a shape or a dot. Okay, so back to your question about the future. Due to their limitation of their vision, they cannot see colour, so and in future, they cannot become a driver, they cannot become a pilot, or they cannot join the army force as well. But there are special lenses for curing, but there are special lenses for those who have red and green colorblindness. They can justify correctly. So at the end, they can maybe join it, but for those who have blue and yellow or other colorblindness, they cannot join this.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Candy. Let's take a break and we'll be back soon.
Hi everyone, we are having two different brands of snacks here. Fish.
This one is having 7 cm of diameter. And this one is having 8 cm.
So, as a customer, which one would you buy? Definitely this one, right? Because we will assume it's having a larger quantity of snacks. However, let me tell you the truth.
With the scales, the larger one is having 150 grams of snack and the smaller one is also having 150 grams of snack.
So, the other brand is using optical illusion to cheat you. Be smart, buy fish snack.
Words can't bring me down. Take two plain white tees. The products are identical, but look at how a simple swoosh instantly increases the price. This is where branding changes our perceived reality. Color, believe it or not, can also increase perceived value. Take two jewelry boxes, for example. If one was colored blue, consumers may think, "Oh my God, Tiffany's!" They perceive a higher value associating the color with a high quality brand. Take Cheerios versus Fruit Loops. To children, the vibrant colors are perceived to be tastier, and therefore advertising color to kids increases the perceived value of the product. Also, simply stating superior product quality can increase consumer perceived value. When broccoli was advertised as the miracle food, marketers found there was a dramatic increase in broccoli sales.
Show vitamins and minerals, all lovingly packed into these tiny green trees.
Hey girl, where is your partner today? Because I always say you are with him before this. Really? Sorry. So, hi, we are back.
I found an interesting scenario just now because this audience was always with her partner before and I thought they were coupled, but in fact they are not.
There is actually a principle to explain this situation. It is actually proximity principle. We tend to group those objects together.
I knew it. Is it the Gestalt
law of perceptual organization?
Oh, I heard about it before. Is there another four principles for that?
Yeah, there actually has four more principles for it. The first is Fiegel-Brown principle. When we perceive an image, we tend to simplify it by dividing it into bigger and round. So bigger is the object we perceive, and the ground is everything in the background. Oh, there's a picture for it. Can you see three figures on it? When you see the tree as a beaker, the gorilla and the lion are the ground.
Oh, so how about next one?
Oh, it's the continuous.
objects that continue in pattern. So you will see the straight line and the curved line. And the other one is similarity principle. We will group the objects that are similar together. So we will not think the yellow figures are in a group with the black figures. Lastly is closure principle. Even when we are looking at an incomplete figure, we can still see a finished unit from it. Oh, thanks for your explanation, Dr. Hani.
That's all for our show today. Special thanks to our guests. See you next time!
Since you mentioned that your husband is a colorblindness, but you didn't mention if you have a son, your son will have 50% chances that he will be colorblind, and another 50% he will not get colorblind or carrier at all. But you have a doctor.
Hi, where's your partner today? Hey, hi, where's your partner? Hey, hey, where's your partner? Hey, hi girl, where's your partner today?